Welcome to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. South Carolina has punched its ticket into the national championship game Sunday night. They take care of Louisville 72-59. Who will join them, UConn or Stanford? Here's how they got there. Outstanding play from their guards. Destiny Henderson leading the charge with three threes. Great decision making. And Aaliyah Boston. Yeah, she's the player of the year for a reason. 23 points, 18 rebounds in the win against Louisville. Meanwhile, in the second game of our semifinal doubleheader, Tara Vanderveer, Gino Auriemma, the two winningest coaches in the history of women's basketball. As we welcome you courtside again, hey everybody, Ryan Rucco along with the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. We'll hear from Holly Rowe and Andrea Carter in just a moment. Rebecca, it was an unforgettable Elite Eight matchup that got UConn here, and it was a memorable finish from Paige Beckers that helped them punch their ticket.
Gino Auriemma talks about Paige Beckers being built for these moments, and she certainly was in that game against NC State. She has the ability to get to the places on the floor where she wants to go, able to drain the shot. 23 points in the second half and overtimes of this game. Connecticut not here without a spectacular performance from Beckers.
Beckers in the second half and overtime. Not only the 23 points with 15 in the two overtimes, but she was 8 of 9 from the floor and 6 of 6 from the line. And Holly Rowe, this is a particularly special Final Four for the Minnesota Kid.
Well, that's right. It all started right here, about 10 minutes away from the Target Center where we're at right now in Hopkins, Minnesota. Paige Beckers was a star at a very young age. Sixth grade, somebody tweeted out that she reminded them of Diana Taurasi, and that has come true. She was actually on the varsity high school team as an eighth grader and led her team to the state championship that year. She finally won the state title when she was a junior on a team that went 32-0. She told me earlier, you know, some teams lose and go home, but I won and I'm still going home. She said it felt so good to drive in from the airport. She knew right away she was back home when somebody handed her something, and she said, thank you. And they said, you betcha. Let's go now to Andrea Carter.
Thanks, Holly. Well, for Stanford's Haley Jones, this might feel like home to her as she was the most outstanding player in the tournament last season. And really, what makes her so special is that she can play the positions 1 through 5. She's got the skill set of a guard, but if you put a guard on her, she will post them up, down low. Just an incredible feel for the game. She can knock you down defensively, block shots, just an intense amount of energy that she plays with. But my favorite part about her game is her ability to facilitate. She leads the team in assists, can put the ball right on the money where it needs to go to lead her teammates to the basket. Haley Jones said she wants to be smooth operating at all positions. They'll need that tonight.
She was the Spokane region most outstanding player. You see what Jones has done thus far in this NCAA tournament. Let's learn more about Haley and her teammates. It's now time for the Capital One Meet the Players.
Hi, everybody. I'm Haley Jones, a point forward on the San Francisco basketball team. I may be a smooth operator on the court, but I'm also most likely to trip on a flat line. Next up, we got guard Anna Wilson. She's so old, she can get her own car insurance this summer. Next up, we got forward Cameron Brink. She'll block your shot and the court and your DMs. Next up, we got guard Lacey Hull. She would let Mike Tyson punch her mom in the face before she let a puppy die. Lastly, we got Lexi Hull. I trust her to drive through the lane, but I would never set foot in her car.
Really funny stuff there. You see these coaching greats. How about 2,305 combined wins between Tara Vanderveer and Gino Auriemma? 14 combined national championships. 11 of them belong to UConn. Let's meet Gino's team.
Hey, I'm Avina Westbrook, senior guard, all the way from the West Coast from Salem, Oregon, here to introduce you with our starting five. Freshman? Did somebody say freshman? You guys know this curly little light-skinned girl, AZ Fudd. Paige Buckets! Excuse me, I mean Beckers. Oh, Canada! And you can't miss her with the Laker-colored braids, my girl, Leah Edwards. Oh, Libby Poo! always about her fashion, Olivia Nelson Ododa. Our Southern girl is here, and she's bringing heat, Kristen Williams.
Pretty fun way to meet both teams. Excellent personality. It's Stanford and it's UConn playing for the first time since 2017. Two incredibly decorated programs. UConn in its 14th straight Final Four, the first for that young woman, AZ Fudd, who has been tremendous throughout this tournament, and Tara Vanderveer's team. Wow, were they loose at shoot-around earlier today, Rebecca? It is a confident defending national championship group.
Certainly, a team that has been here before and was acting like it, making their shots, having fun, enjoying the moment before it's time to get serious.
It was something six-year player Anna Wilson talked to us about the other day. She said, our experience here keeps us loose. We have seen that manifest thus far during this run for Stanford. Meanwhile, can UConn get enough out of its bigs to match the talented front court and the deep front court of Stanford? UConn, of course, will be without Dorca Juhas, who fractured her wrist in the Elite Eight matchup against NC State. She is here with her team, which Gino Auriemma thought would provide quite the boost for his group. You heard L tell the joke of Gino saying, well, of course, in the game we need her length most, we won't have her. This semifinal is underway. UConn wins the tip. Connecticut and Stanford playing for a spot in the national championship game against South Carolina. Here's Williams. Beckers dumps it in. Nelson Ododa with Jones shading. Nelson Ododa under 10 to shoot. Edwards finds Williams mid-range. Sure.
You saw in that first possession, Stanford defensively will play way off of Connecticut's two big players when they are on the perimeter. It's going to be important for Aaliyah Edwards to be able to make 15-footers tonight, Ryan.
Williams had 21 in the Elite Eight win. Here's Brink. No. And the weak side rebound to Edwards. Edwards had a massive putback in that second overtime. Just a classic game against NC State. AZ Fudd, a little too strong. Rebound ends up with Lacey Hall. Her twin sister, Lexi. Also part of the ball handling duties for a Stanford team that does it by committee. Nice defense there as Paige Becker held her ground.
Yeah, did a really great job of maintaining defensive position, having her arms straight up in the air.
Williams will fire. No. And the rebound, Lexi. Lexi Hall has been the leading scorer in the NCAA tournament thus far, averaging 22 points per game. Doing it on 52% shooting. Here's Jones. Raising up, left it short. Rebound loose on the floor. Jones can't put it in, and finally UConn collects.
Tara Vanderveer talked to us about the keys to this game. Number one, rebounding. Both teams have done a good job on the defensive glass.
Beckers is on the board in her hometown.
Taps Cameron Brink on the butt on the way back. Those two have been teammates with USA Basketball.
Haley Jones, Fran Belibi, AZ Fudd also have been a part of it. Lexi Hull rims off. Nice box out from Nelson Ododa and a strong start here from UConn. Here's Beckers. Lost it. Good hands from Lexi Hall. Stanford 0 for 5 from the floor in the early going.
Connecticut doing a good job switching between man-to-man and zone defense so far in this game.
Brink bodies in. Can't finish it. Got it back. Held ball, and it will remain with Stanford.
Paige Becker's as good as it gets coming off the ball screen. Defender gets caught up. Brink right there to contest. And watch him coming back down. Oh, she gave her a little tap. I got you, my friend.
Becker's has come back to life here in the NCAA tournament after missing 19 games in the middle of the season, having surgery on her knee. As Nelson Ododa's denial will keep it here. And since Paige Becker's return, took a little while for her to get her scoring going. She told us during the Sweet 16, Rebecca. Look, I know I'm not going to be last year's Paige Beckers. Well, in the second half and overtime, she looked like last year's Paige Beckers against NC State.
When she first came back, she did not want to be disruptive to her team who had been having success. As you see Cameron Brink hitting the turnaround, I think she realizes now, forget about being disruptive. Hey, my team needs me to look for some scoring.
Beckers, the player of the year last season, set a UConn freshman record for scoring, which is incredible when you consider the freshmen that the Huskies have had throughout the years. And that's going to be an offensive foul against Edwards. Stanford basketball. Here's a look from the target above the rim cap.
Cameron Brink has great length, and she can score inside. Little fade because she's shooting over Olivia Nelson-Adota, who also has length. And Ryan, that's a big foul on Aaliyah Edwards.
Especially without Dorka Juhas, the depth of the UConn front court will be tested. Juhas would have been the third big in rotation. And Edwards and Nelson-Adota, they can get in foul trouble.
And when Connecticut is in man-to-man, it's Edwards who has the task of Haley Jones.
Paige Beckers skies for the rebound over Anna Wilson. Here's Williams. Good anticipation there from Lacey. Beckers draws out Brink, and a kickball. We'll keep it here with UConn. And an early sub from Stanford. Hannah Jump will come in for Wilson. Now, the interesting thing about Stanford is you don't see many collegiate teams get to this point in the season and play 11 players, but Stanford will do that. As another kick is called. You heard us talk about the analogy last year. Tara Vanderveer talks about the orchestra. You never know which player's night it is to solo. Well, that holds true for this group as well.
Said a fewer solos this year. It's much more of an ensemble than it was a season ago.
Without Kiana Williams now. Jones tried the box out. Nelson-Adota pinned, finds Beckers. No. And Haley Jones, the rebound. Good looks in the early going for both teams, but not going down. Jump! And stepped out of bounds as Stanford turns it over.
Yeah, neither team's shooting great, but they both like this place.
Yeah.
They want to get up and down the floor. Tara Vanderveer told us this morning, the faster the better.
And Gino Auriemma told us as well, we have to play fast. So hold on to your seat as you're watching at home. Beckers trying to sell the call on Brink. She could not. Still time here. Edwards doesn't hit, but that's the jumper you're talking about.
Yeah, you saw the defense slacking way off of Edwards. They will do the same with Nelson-Adota.
Brink spins, flips, can't hit. Nice box out from Nelson-Adota. Both teams shooting it poorly in the early going. UConn 2-for-7. Stanford 1-for-9. Here's Spud finding a little space. Can't get it to go. Edwards had it ripped away by Lacey Hall. Passing it to her twin Lexi. Lexi pedaling into traffic. Got fouled by Spud, and free throws for Lexi. Where did it all begin for Gino Auriemma? We learn next. The last time the Final Four was in Minneapolis, we recognize those two. Yeah, Tara Vanderveer, Gino Auriemma, UConn, and Rebecca Lobo leading the way against Stanford in the semi. And then look at that baseline, Jay, from number 50. The Lobos love it. The first national championship for UConn and a young Gino Auriemma.
I mean, we're 35-0. We won a national championship. I don't know what to tell you. I really don't. I can't be eloquent at this time because it's just not. I don't know what it means to me. I'm just really happy for my players. That's what it means to me. It means, you know, we played 35 games and didn't lose any of them. I mean, that's just. Why would I want to come back and coach this team next year? No matter what we do, there's no way it could be any better than this.
Lives were changed that weekend in Minneapolis, and that's the exciting thing about this Final Four, Ryan. Some of these kids and coaches' lives could be changed this weekend in Minneapolis.
Rebecca Lobo, the Naismith Player of the Year in 1995, the first UConn National Championship in school history. What do you remember most about that weekend?
The celebration afterwards.
So you're saying things haven't changed that much through the years then, huh?
That's right. When you look back, though, I know my life would be completely different if we had not won that game. And it's so exciting watching these young women on the floor to know that for some of them, things will never be the same again after this weekend.
Pretty amazing. And we're grateful you took the path you did after that run around the court. Little blood here for Lexi Hull. So she is going to check out for the moment, be tended to. Anna Wilson is going to shoot these free throws. Now, it would have been Hull who would have been shooting the free throws, but she's going to maybe have to take a little time and care over there. Remember, she could still come back in the game, unlike in a pro situation where if she didn't shoot the free throw, she cannot. 4-3, UConn in front of Stanford. Maybe some jitters in the early going with all the missed shots?
Yeah, I think so.
Fudd got that one to drop. Paige Becker's getting a breather here for UConn. Nika Mule, Big East Defensive Player of the Year, is in.
This is Connecticut's small lineup with Avina Westbrook playing the four position.
Even more important without Dorka Juhas. Belivi off the bench, doesn't get the roll. Westbrook secures. Here comes Williams racing ahead. The pull-up, no. Mule there on the follow. And it's going to be Stanford basketball as Mule turns it over. Hey, fans, don't forget to check out the Bird and Taurasi show presented by AT&T 5G over on ESPNU, featuring WNBA legends Sue Bird and Diana Taurasi, as well as special guests throughout Final Four weekend. On Sunday, the show will air live at 8 p.m. Eastern on ESPN2.
I'm going to go back and watch it.
Yeah. When those two are together, it's trouble, and it's entertaining trouble. Shot clock down to five. Jones trying to create the footwork and the finish with the left hand. How about the creativity of Haley Jones?
How many times did we see that in last year's Final Four when Stanford's offense couldn't find something easy? You get the ball to Haley Jones and she was able to get a good look. Same thing here.
She was the most outstanding player at the Final Four en route to Stanford's third national championship. Fudd dumps it in. Nelson Adota, deep seal, couldn't finish it. Loose ball picked up by Jones. A 6-5 UConn lead. Oh, nice hands by Fudd. Can she save it? No. And it's out of bounds to Stanford as Beckers will check back in.
Haley Jones here just coming off the screen. Good defense, but gets a step and steps through. Haley Jones is excellent offensively. Anytime she catches the ball at the free throw line area or gets there off the bounce.
Monique and Patrick, Haley's parents, in attendance to watch their star daughter play in the Final Four once again. Oh, Lacey, nice crossover. Doesn't get the roll. Westbrook the rebound, and here comes Beckers back in and pushing for UConn. Fudd, run off, the pull-up is good. AZ Fudd has such a true stroke.
And you have to contest her hard because she has a little space at the three-point line. She can drain it.
Beckers and Mule combine on the steal. Williams on the bench now for the Huskies. Here's Mule. Sophomore from Croatia. Beckers cross court. Westbrook unable to hit from three, and Jones left for the board.
Great box out by Fran Belivi, and now running the floor hard.
Jones forces it in, plus the foul. Paige Beckers whistled for her first personal, and Jones a chance for three.
Haley Jones at 6-1 can get inside and then score over smaller defenders. Paige Becker's overall a pretty good job, but at the end, flicked down and got Jones on the wrist. So dangerous.
You heard Drea talk about it in the open, but we're asking Jones about her game, and she said, they call me operator because I just try and be smooth with everything I do. She is going to be an outstanding pro when that time comes as well. Wilson falls. Newell, extra feed. Westbrook on the attack. Good movement here. Edwards, though, missed it too strong. Another one of those opportunities we're talking about.
That's the shot Stanford wants Connecticut's players to take.
Brink facing up, flipped it short. Edwards flags it down. Stanford is just 3 for 14 from the floor. UConn is 4 for 14. See Brink sagging off of Edwards. Here's Becker's pull up, not a lot of airspace, and it didn't matter. Cameron Brink draped all over Becker's there, and she still was able to hit.
Phenomenal defense.
Here's Brink, quick move on the attack to the reverse. Cameron Brink, a third team All-American this season. Her and Haley Jones becoming the first pair of Stanford teammates to both be All-Americans since the Agumike sisters, Eka and Chinay. Newell looking for help, lost the defender, missed the bunny. Edwards on the follow.
Great activity and persistence by Aaliyah Edwards on that possession.
15 seconds left in the quarter. Shot clock is turned off. UConn a three-point lead. Becker's the deflection. Jones the collection. Westbrook the block. Still time for UConn. Here comes Westbrook. 2 seconds left. Becker's can't hit the three. And that's how the first quarter will end. UConn a three-point lead after one in this semifinal. Holly Rowe will chat with Gino Auriemma in his 22nd Final Four. That's next on ESPN.
Coach, a low-scoring first quarter. Your defense has been a big reason why you're here. What have they done well so far?
Well, we've kind of kept them, away from doing what they like to do. We've tried to keep them off balance a little bit. But it's always a low-scoring game in these games early on. You know, both teams are trying to figure each other out. Shots are not easy to make, during this tournament. We got to get some help from our big guys on offense. You know, we can't just expect to come out here and make 42 jump shots, to win this game. So hopefully now everybody's settled in.
We talked about their length. How are you attacking it so far?
Well, we're not really. We're kind of settling for a couple things, but I think if we can get in the lane a little bit more and force them to make a play, then I think we'll be all right.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
One of the things we saw in that first quarter, Rebecca, was Paige Becker's finding her shot over Cameron Brink.
Tara Vanderveer trusting Cameron Brink to switch out whenever there's an on-ball screen on Paige Becker's, and Cameron Brink's done a pretty good job of contesting her friend, but Paige Becker's has done a better job of hitting the shots, and then when she does and they go back down the floor, you see Brink with a big smile, Becker's with the tap. Two competitors having fun out there.
Let's take a look at our first quarter stats. They are brought to you by Geico. Paige with 4 points on 2 of 4 shooting. Both teams struggled to hit shots in that first quarter for Stanford. It's their fewest points in a quarter in this tournament. And Rebecca, you've talked about it before, and Holly alluded to it there with Gino. These teams are known for their offense, but they can get after it on the other end.
Yeah, outstanding defensive team. Stanford known for their scouting report defense, knowing who to help off of, who to slough off of. They've done a really good job of that so far.
Here's Becker's finding Fudd. Fudd, pull-up jumper, a little too strong. Jones able to secure the rebound with Westbrook and Edwards in pursuit. Winner of this game will face South Carolina Sunday night, 8 Eastern on ESPN. South Carolina taking care of Louisville. 72-59 in the first game tonight as Hull loses it out of bounds. Last touch, Lexi, who is playing with some cotton up in that nostril.
She got a step barely on Paige Becker's, but Paige Becker's has length and able to disrupt the pass. Playing with a little cotton?
Yeah. I've done it before.
In athletic competition?
Just life.
Fun.
Yeah.
Well, guys, there's a reason she's back out on the court. Tara said she gets so mad when I take her out of the game. She'd play every second if she could. Even if she's got a bloody nose, blood on her jersey, she's going to get right back out there, and here she is.
And it's those kind of plays, Holly, that make such a difference. Fighting with the bigger Edwards. Edward gets called for the foul. That's her second. And so Aaliyah Edwards goes to the bench. Nelson Adota back in. And remember, UConn is down their third rotation post when it comes to Brophy Juhas.
Gino Auyama told Holly Rowe we need more out of our post. So you know he said the same thing in the huddle. So that time, Edwards trying to post up hard.
And now Fudd is going to pick up her second personal as Lexi will massage her way to the line. And as a result, Gino Auyama is going to come and get AZ Fudd. Caroline Ducharme will check in for Fudd. It was interesting talking with Lexi Hull about her expanded offensive game, leading the nation in scoring during the tournament. She said what's helped her actually score more is being more patient, not trying to force her shot early in the game, trying to make her early looks easy ones, and that usually frees her up the rest of the game. That's out of bounds off of Nelson Adota, Stanford basketball.
Another way of saying, like, let the game come to you.
Yeah.
Don't force things early in the game. Don't force things early in the possession, especially on a Stanford team where you have to guard everybody. Everybody who's out there can score.
You see, Lexi led the team in scoring each of the last three games, had 36 in the second round, most by a Stanford player since 2014. Made so many key plays in last year's championship run as Brink finds an angle. Cameron Brink now with six. Eight field goal attempts for Brink, most of any player on the floor. Beckers, no. Rebound Jones. Haley Jones already with six boards in this game. Lexi airmails it. Loose ball. Who's going to get it? It's underneath Brink, and the possession arrow belongs to Stanford.
Andrea, one of the things that you look for when you're coaching post players, try to get to the basket in one dribble, and Brink, you saw her do that on that possession. Huge first step.
Stanford has not led yet in this game. Beckers gets fouled by Lexi. And that will be the first personal on Lexi Hull. It'll be the first foul against Stanford. Drea? Westbrook backing away. Gets it out to Beckers. Nelson Adota with four to shoot. Westbrook gonna have to pull. On the run, can't float it in. Here comes Lacy. UConn now 6 for 22 from the floor. Jones finding some space. Line drive won't go. Lexi follows it up.
Man, that's vintage Lexi Hull right there. Just out scrapping, yeah.
Stanford's 5 for 20. Both teams shooting under 30%. In the corner, jump. Run off the line, throws it off a leg, then throws it into the backcourt, and that's going to be a violation and a turnover. Good D from UConn.
Avina Westbrook has been terrific since she came in the game. She has been absolutely terrific. Lots of energy, competing hard, playing the four position for Connecticut.
So interesting, Rebecca, because as good as these teams are defensively, as you illustrated a moment ago, as Jana Van Guytenbeek checks in for Stanford, but they play a pretty offensive style, and obviously they have not been able to do that thus far in this first half.
It's also important to remember they run very similar continuity offense, and so you know how to defend it. You know where they want to cut. You know how to prevent that from happening.
Connecticut has missed its last five shots. Williams back in. Ducharme goes to Westbrook in the corner on a three. That's big for Connecticut.
you saw in the previous possession. They were leaving Avina Brustwick wide open for that shot.
Lacey couldn't finish it. Brink wrestles it away and gets the whistle against Nelson Adota. What insistence from Cameron Brink, and free throws here for Brink.
Avina Westbrook wide open by design. Previous possession, when the ball went into the post, they helped off of Avina Westbrook. They want her taking, Stanford wants her taking that shot. She shoots 30% from three.
Stanford 1-for-5 from the line.
See Gina Orianna talking to the officials, saying Stanford has one foul called on them.
Six on UConn, and you see Sonya Curry, the mother of Steph and Seth, there with the Brink family. Sonya, the godmother to Cameron Brink. Cameron seeing the Brink family last year after the national championship. So excited for Cameron, and also asking, now how do we keep her from fouling? She's gotten so much better at that this season as Beckers floats it in.
She's done a great job so far in this game because she has contested well without fouling. We've seen how important she is on the offensive end of the floor.
Brink working Nelson Adota. Brink slides in. Couldn't finish it. Believe and Nelson Adota tied up. Who did last hit? Last hit UConn. And it's going to be Stanford basketball.
Paige Becker is just smartly going away from the screen as the defense overplayed. And how many tough shots have we seen her hit so far in this game?
Been incredible. Lexi floats it out. Another chance here for Stanford after the effort on the offensive glass. And that is a silly foul from Nelson Adota. And the coaching staff of UConn immediately saying, you can't do it. That's number two now on Nelson Adota. Holly?
Well, guys, you're just showing how Paige Becker's moves on the floor. And Gina Auriemma said something to us fascinating. He said she flows like water. The way she's able to get into the cracks and creases of all of the gaps makes it very difficult to defend.
Here's Lexi finding space and finishing with the left hand.
Interesting to me too, Ryan, as Connecticut's had to go small, Stanford has gone very big. Beliebe, Brink, Jones, all in the game.
And the holes are big guards as well.
No one under 6 feet on the floor for Stanford.
Westbrook bounces in. Nelson Adota lost it. Now remember, Edwards on the bench with two fouls. Budd on the bench with two fouls. Nelson Adota on the floor with two. Two-point UConn lead under 5 minutes to go in this first half. South Carolina awaits the winner. Good hands there from Kristen Williams, coming up with a steal. Here's Ducharme on the attack. Beckers trying to cut through traffic, separates and finishes. That's a tough bucket for Paige Beckers. Jones doesn't get the roll. Westbrook the rebound. Now, we are checking one thing, Rebecca. Whether or not that first foul on Nelson Adota, they ended up giving elsewhere, as Nelson Adota can't finish here. She may have just one. Gonna check if there was a change in the official scoring on her first. As Jones floats it in.
Not an answer for Haley Jones, and she's going in one-on-one. Skills of a guard. She has the post moves back to the basket as well.
Beckers gives it up. Westbrook connects on another three. Gina Auriemma told us the other day she's the kind of player who can hit some big shots in a game like this, as Jones delivers a perfect pass to Beliebe.
Perfectly placed pass because there was no help side defense there. Beliebe bigger and wider than Westbrook, able to seal. Well done.
Westbrook, the transfer from Tennessee. Stanford a 16-4 edge, points in the paint. Beckers Tosses back to Westbrook. Lexi fronting Nelson Adota in the post. Westbrook again! Avina Westbrook, her third three of the quarter. Six-point UConn lead. Belibi the spin and the tough finish. Fran Belibi having a big tournament off the bench for Stanford.
I think you keep going there. She's got the size advantage on Westbrook, and you really can't help from the weak side because it's loaded with three-point shooters.
Talk about those USA players who are all friends with each other. Fran Belibi, another one of them. And a foul here as Brink hits the floor. It's going to go against Cameron Brink. Her first. A four-point UConn lead. Avina Westbrook getting hot.
Avina Westbrook has shown tremendous toughness this year. At times a starter, at times coming in off the bench. This is always a bonus for Connecticut when she can drain a three, and she's done it here multiple times.
That trophy is on the line. South Carolina will play for it Sunday night. Who will join them? Will it be UConn or Stanford? Coming up in the Degree Halftime Report with Elle Duncan, Carolyn Peck, Nikki Fargus. There are wonderful women. South Carolina back in the title game. And Dawn Staley will be live on the set. That's all coming up at the half. UConn a 25-21 lead over Stanford, 2:11 to go in this second quarter. Stanford, the longest winning streak in the nation, 24 straight entering this game. Their last loss December 21st at South Carolina. By the way, it was reconfirmed, two fouls on Nelson Adota. Nelson Adota remains on the floor, Edwards on the bench with two, Fudd on the bench with two for UConn.
Ashton Prechtel in the game for Stanford. They can just bring waves of size at you.
Right there, great contest from Prechtel on Williams. Lacy dishes out, dug up by Jump, who buries the three. Hannah Jump. All but one of her field goal attempts in this tournament have been from three.
You knew it was only going to be a matter of time for Stanford to start hitting from the outside before that shot. 0 for 7 outside the paint.
Beckers, no. Nelson Adota, another chance, but she throws it to Steve Lavoe, our stat man, who is not wearing a UConn uniform. Turned over.
Hannah Jump, a terrific three-point shooter. Stanford has three players who shoot 40% or better from the perimeter, and that's all created by Hull. Deep dribble penetration draws the defense, gives Jump plenty of time.
Last tournament, Stanford set a record for most threes made in a tournament. They shot it well over 40% from three during the tournament as Jones reverses it in, and Stanford has the lead, their first of the night.
Simply no answer defensively for Haley Jones off the bounce.
Now the Stanford fans on their feet behind the bench of the Cardinal in what is a very heavily pro UConn crowd, and a foul here against Stanford. It'll be just the third personal of the game against the Cardinal.
A little bit of a screen, and Avina Westbrook gets caught up, but what a tough finish by Haley Jones using her size, strength, no chance of blocking that one.
Jones, 8 points, six rebounds. She also has just made so many plays when her team has needed it to stay afloat in this first half. Mule into the game for Ducharme. A lot of contact there between Lexi and Paige. Here's Paige dishing it out. Corner three, off the mark for Williams. Nelson Adota, Mule gets it to go, plus the foul. A chance for three for Nika Mule.
Nika Mule has not played a ton of minutes in the NCAA tournament, but every time she has come in, she's made a difference. She's impactful. One of the smaller players on the floor, but in the right spot and able to finish the and one. One of the more emotional players on the floor as well.
She's a director's dream. Jimmy Platt has a field day with Nika Mule layups. As Mule can't hit the free throw, loose ball, Jones has it. But you know, Oriyama told us, Nika Mule is a game changer for us. Said she changed our season entering the starting lineup this season. She changed our season when she entered it last season. And the blood is again rushing down for Lexi Hull. So she's going to have to go back to the bench. And who knows whether or not she'll get back in before this game gets to halftime. Hannah Wilson in.
The incredible toughness of Lazio.
Paige and Lacey get tied up. Paige wanted a call, did not get one. 15 second difference, game and shot clock. Jones surveying. Jones got it away, left it short, Mule the rebound. UConn can hold for a final shot, and Gino Auriemma going to slow them down to do so. Both teams have started to shoot it better in the latter portion of this second quarter. 5 seconds left in the half. Westbrook, one more. No. Rebound, Stanford, and that will do it for the first half. A one-point UConn lead at halftime with a trip to the national championship game on the line and South Carolina waiting. What a half for Avina Westbrook. And a nice half from Haley Jones as well, who is with Holly Rupp.
Well, Haley, a lot of missed shots in that first quarter. How were the nerves early, and how has your team settled down now?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it was quite nerves. We're just not hitting. We're just not playing Stanford basketball right now. We've been in this situation before. It's not nerves. We're just not hitting. So I think that's a boost of confidence going into the second half. No, we have so much more to give.
When you say Stanford basketball, what does it have to be in the second half?
We've got to be moving the ball on offense. We're taking the right shots. We just got to hit. We're tugging on defense. I think we're doing pretty good. They're one of the best offensive teams in the country. They only got 27. We're playing awful on offense. We got 26. So then we got a lot of growth in the second half.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Holly.
The incredible poise of Haley Jones. You can see why she's such a great leader, saying, hey, we're getting the shots we want. We just got to hit them in the second half. Paige Beckers and UConn, a one-point lead at halftime. Elle Duncan, Carolyn Peck, Nikki Fargus coming up. Avina Westbrook, three threes in that first half. 9 points. You see the first four games of the tournament average less than 5 points per game. Found money for UConn at a time when they really needed it. So we begin the second half, one-point game, a trip to the national championship game Sunday night, 8 p.m. Eastern on ESPN is on the line. Edwards and Fudd back in, sat a lot of the second quarter with two fouls apiece. Edwards can't hit. Nelson Adota, the offensive rebound. Nelson Adota got fouled by Brink. That will be the second personal on Cameron Brink, and Nelson Adota will shoot two.
I thought Cameron Brink had a really good defensive position, and Nelson Adota threw her off arm in to get the foul. But until then, Cameron Brink has been playing terrific defense, contesting hard without fouling. That's pretty good for her to not get a first one until this part of the game. So offensive board by Nelson Adota. She goes and gets it. Now, when she makes her move, it was her off arm that swung, and I thought created the contact.
Hit the second free throw, her first point of the game. That's number two on Brink. Stanford 6 for its last 8 from the floor after they had started 5 for 22. This is an incredible offensive team. Maybe starting to find its rhythm at the end of the half. You heard Haley Jones telling Holly, hey, we're going to start making our shots, and she makes her first here in the third quarter.
Again, no answer for her so far in this game.
10.7 rebound. She was the Final Four's most outstanding player a season ago. A two-time All-American now. Williams shovels out. Here's Beckers. And that's going to be an illegal screen on Nelson Adota, and that will be her third. So Gino Auriemma already down Dorca Juhas, his third post. Now has to worry about Nelson Adota in foul trouble. She played most of the second quarter with two, was able to navigate. Now she's here in the third with three.
From Stanford, I go right at her. Get the ball to Cameron Brink. Get a fourth on Nelson Adota.
You know, Auriemma told us we don't need our posts to be great to win this game. We just need them to be solid to good. Jones, not that time. Williams, the rebound. Knew he'd need great performances out of his guards. Like Beckers. Hesitation, curl it up and off. Nelson Adota couldn't grab it. Edwards does. Another chance here for Connecticut. Here's Williams. Barreling in. And nice D from Lacey Hull.
Great help defense as well from Stanford, and they can do that by helping off of Connecticut's post players.
Williams now 1-for-7 from the floor, has just 2 points. The senior who has found consistency this season. In the corner, Jones off the mark on a three. Becker's the weak side rebound. Jones just 27% from three this season. Here's Becker's curling and hitting. The Minnesota kid with 10 points now, coming off her epic double overtime performance in the Elite Eight against NC State. Lexi doesn't get the roll. Nice box out from Nelson Adota. He's done a nice job on the glass. 9 boards now. Beckers to the corner. Fudd traveled.
Been really impressed by Haley Jones. Look at the jab step. She called herself a point forward when announcing the starting lineup. That jab step is a guard move and a beautiful shot, and we've seen Paige Becker's shine. Another tough shot over a contest.
Yeah, Connecticut hasn't had an answer, Drea, for Haley Jones when she's looked to go one-on-one. Again, she's a smooth operator from that free throw line area, and Paige Becker's as good as they come in the college game off of the on-ball screen.
Prechtl, look out! Ashton Prechtl can change a game. We saw it in the Elite Eight last year against Louisville when she scored 16 second half points, did not miss. Beckers got it to go. 12 now for Paige and a timeout taken. UConn will take a timeout. It's a one-point Connecticut lead, 6:37 to go in the third quarter of the semifinal.
Stanford can send size and skill at you in waves. 6'5", Ashton Prechtl draining the three. Bench celebrating. Paige Becker's another tough one. Buckets.
UConn, a one-point lead over Stanford in this semifinal. How about the coaches left with the men's and women's Final Four? Coach K, 13 Final Four appearances, 5 titles. You see the credentials for Tara Vanderveer and Gino Auriemma. It's just remarkable the sustained success of these programs and coaches. UConn in its 22nd Final Four. Stanford in its 15th.
Connecticut out of that timeout, extending their pressure here. Stanford, 7 seconds to go on the shot clock. One of the reasons you pick up full.
Wilson, no. Nice box out there from Kristen Williams.
Change up the pace a little bit by extending your defense. That's what Connecticut did after the timeout.
Brink on the bench for Stanford. Nelson Adota on the bench for UConn. Nice look. Beckers, Williams, in and out on a three. Edwards trying to go up strong with it, and does. Gino Auriemma loved the play of Edwards in the second half against NC State.
She can be a difference maker on the offensive glass. Great instincts.
3-point Connecticut lead. South Carolina awaits the winner. Lacey, little hesitation. Lost her footing, was able to get it off to Jones. Lacey left alone in the corner, no. Loose ball, Wilson has it, another chance for Stanford. Stanford 2-for-8 now from 3-point range. This is an outstanding 3-point shooting team. They haven't gotten them to drop yet tonight. Jones way off the mark. Westbrook veering, exploding, can't finish. Prechtl hauls it in. Good hands by Fudd. Jones able to corral it. Stanford with plenty of time to set things up. Stanford on a 24-game winning streak, longest active streak in the nation. Jones will fire. No. Rebound. Out of bounds off of Prechtl. Connecticut basketball. A three-point lead for UConn. Trying to play for his 12th national championship on Sunday night if they can win this one. Stanford trying to become back-to-back champs. South Carolina waits in the wings. Connecticut a three-point third-quarter lead over Stanford, Drea.
Well, Ryan, there's a lot of activity that can go unnoticed in this great game. And when I look back at this play, it's Avena Westbrook's role that draws in the defense and gives Paige Beckers the opportunity to find Kristen Williams in the corner. The shot doesn't go in, but it is a quality three-point look. And then Aaliyah Edwards is still able to get the offensive rebound, but it started with the roll to the basket from Avena Westbrook.
Avena Westbrook has been absolutely terrific off the bench at the guard or forward spot for Connecticut. Gino Auriemma told us coming into this game that he needed his trio of guards to be as good as they were against NC State. AZ Fudd, Kristen Williams in that game combined for 40 points. Those two have struggled a little bit here. Paige Beckers has done her part.
And yet UConn still a plus 13 in backcourt points. Now remember, Stanford has kind of used an ensemble cast when it comes to their point guard ball handling duties this season. Lacey talked about how we really committed to it as a group, five of us sharing the responsibilities after Kiana Williams graduated last season. Here's Beckers, threw it away into the chest of Lacey Hull. It was like she didn't see her. Brechtel will fire. No. Jones, the offensive rebound, and a foul's called against Mule. That will be Mule's first. And the second team foul against UConn in his third quarter. Nelson Adota's been on the bench with three. Edwards and Fudd navigating with two. Their minutes were limited in the first half because of foul trouble. Brechtel wide open, too strong. Jumped the rebound. Another chance here for Stanford. Lexi, ball fake, attack, jumper, won't go, rebound Mule, a lot of good chances on that possession for Stanford, nothing dropping. Beckers will back it out. Thud just tosses it away, Lacey comes up with a steal, and it forces Edwards' third foul. So the poor pass from Fudd results in Edwards' third personal.
Something similar to what we saw in the first game that fouled Emily Engsler out is when your guard passes it bad and you got to go try to collect it. And instead, Edwards gets the foul called.
All 12 field goal attempts from Stanford have come outside the paint in this third quarter after they had scored 20 points in the paint in the first half.
Only four assists on the day from Stanford.
With one of the best ball movement teams in the country. Brink back in, wants it on Edwards. Knows she has three fouls and takes advantage.
Beautiful post move. Did you see the work she did all in her shoulders to get the defense off balance?
10 points for Cameron Brink. She and Jones, the only two members of Stanford in double figures. Fudd with space. A little too strong on the three. Hazy Fudd is a sharp shooter. She's 0 for 2 from three-point range thus far tonight. Here's Lexi turning the corner. The leaner rolls off. Rebound out of bounds off of Brink. It's Connecticut basketball. Here's a look from the target above the rim cam.
Just watch Cameron bring shoulders when she catches the basketball. Which way am I going to go? Fake, and turn. Beautifully done. And then hands out. You don't only call for the basketball with your mouth. You call for the basketball with your hands. She does it there with her 6'8 wingspan.
Holly?
Well, it doesn't hurt that she has that huge wingspan. 6'8 on that Cameron Brink frame. But, guys, they call it got gangle. Very gangly, but very effective. I like it. Got gangle? Yes, she does.
That's wonderful. Here's Westbrook at three threes in the second quarter. A little hesitation. Westbrook took the body. No call. And Jones comes down with yet another rebound. Her 10th, she has a double-double. Here's Haley Jones. Good hands by Fudd. Knocked it away. Jones insisting. And it's a foul on Westbrook as Haley Jones will shoot two.
We saw it all first half from Haley Jones. When the team, when the Stanford Cardinal having a tough time getting the moving and the cutting that they want, they can. She's the ultimate bailout. Give her the basketball, let her create inside.
Jones ties it. Stanford has not led by more than one at any point. Connecticut had its largest lead with 2:50 to go in the second quarter. It was six. It has been a closely contested game as Jones hits both.
What's interesting, too, is the difference. Like Paige Beckers, you give her a ball screen. That's how she gets a little bit of space. Haley Jones doesn't need a ball screen. She just needs to face the basket and go.
Paige getting a breather on the bench right now. Here's Nelson Adota back in with three fouls. Edwards takes her three to the bench. Williams on a much-needed triple. Had started 0 for 3 from deep. Connecticut's going to need more of that from Kristen Williams to get to the finish line. Here's Jones. So much poise as she surveys. Lexi off the mark on a three. Lexi Hall just 1 for 9 from the floor, the tournament's leading scorer entering this game. Back out, Nelson Adota. Got it! Little mid-range jumper from Nelson Adota.
How about the inside-out game using Avina Westbrook, the smaller forward, as the one posting up.
39-35, Connecticut in front. Brink, trapped, kicks out. One-on-one with Nelson Adota, playing with three. Brink bodies in and finishes.
Again, the clean lane for Stanford, because you have to respect their perimeter shooters. You have to stay with them. That leaves Brink the opportunity to go one-on-one.
12 points, 5 rebounds for the sophomore Brink. 5-second difference, game and shot clock. Connecticut a 2-point lead. Thud gets it to Williams. 5 to shoot. Williams looking to create. Lost the handle and the footing. Over to Stanford. Lacey throws it out of bounds. Or are they going to call a foul here? Paige Beckers will check back in. Bud will check out. Now they're going to say it's Stanford basketball and say it was deflected. It looked like there was contact on the body, but nothing on the basketball. And Gina Auriemma is very confused. Here's Lacey. She gets it off from half court and nearly got it to go. That'll do it for the third quarter. Connecticut a 2-point lead after three. We'll chat with Stanford head coach Tara Vanderveer. Trying to defend her title. She'll chat with Holly. Coming up next, fourth quarter action.
Coach, what's the greatest challenge UConn's defense is presenting from your offense to get more of a flow right now?
Holly, we're just really struggling offensively. We need to move the ball better. I thought we got in trouble. We weren't rebounding. Then we're giving up some easy shots. But we're right there. We just need to be confident and knock down some good shots.
When you say move the basketball better, who are you trying to target to get looks?
We're holding it. We need to move it. We need to move it and run better offense.
Thank you, Coach.
Okay.
Well, Leah Boston and South Carolina waiting to see who they will play Sunday night. 23-18 for Boston in the semifinal win against Louisville. How about Brink here?
Well, Stanford's only 2 of 13 on the game, but you know they have terrific three-point shooters all over the floor. Look how clean that lane is. Brink makes the move. There are only 2 feet in the paint, and that's Olivia Nelson Adota, and it's because you cannot help off on their shooters. Most players love the clean lane.
Cameron Brink having a big night, 12 points, adding 5 rebounds, has kept the foul trouble at a minimum with just 2. Start of the fourth quarter, 2-point game, a trip to the national championship game is on the line. Good hands by Westbrook. UConn with Beckers, Nelson Adota, Ewell, Williams, and Westbrook. Backdoor, Lexi unable to finish. Nice tee from Nelson Adota. Scrap inside, Mule after it, and it's going to be a jump ball, and UConn has possession. Let's check out our game track brought to you by Adidas. Paige Beckers with 12 points, Haley Jones with a double-double, and Stanford after 20 in the paint in the first half, just 4 in that third quarter. The Cardinal did not turn it over in that third quarter. Meanwhile, Connecticut had 5 turnovers in the quarter. Here's Williams, giving it up. Eckers dumps it down. Nelson Adota, the spin and the finish, plus the foul. As Irafin just into the game gets whistled for the personal.
Nelson Adota posting up strong. Help defense is there in time, and the tough finish for Nelson Adota. 1-for-4 from the floor before that, and Paige Becker saying, yeah, you got me, big girl.
Nelson Adota completes the three-point play. Connecticut's lead is 5. Brink back in for Stanford.
Tara was talking in an interview with Holly about not getting a lot of ball movement. When Connecticut can extend their pressure, help take time off the shot clock, it gives Stanford less time to move the ball side to side. Here again, haven't been able to.
Here's Jump. Bouncing in, and a foul is going to go against Mule, who just slaps it away afterwards. Gina Auriemma often jokes about the toughness of Nika Mule. And that's going to be her second personal. Jones spins. Oh, nice touch. Haley Jones now with 14. Westbrook had Williams in the corner, elected for Mule. Beckers looking for some space, couldn't find it. Williams can, and hits! Jump gets lost on the other end, can't answer with a 3. Mule pushing, Connecticut has matched its largest lead of the night. Williams, will she fire again? She will. No. And Brink the board. Connecticut bench was on its feet, ready to celebrate. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter and a 6-point Connecticut lead. A foul against Westbrook. And that will be the second on Westbrook.
Haley Jones is just the ultimate bailout. She's got the size here. She can face up and score. She's got the post move to score. Other end of the floor, Nika Mule, great screen. That's the reason that Kristen Williams was so wide open for the 3.
That's going to be an illegal screen on Brink. And she sent Beckers to the deck, then helps her up, those two friends. And Tara Vanderveer, you heard her tell Holly they're a little out of sorts offensively tonight. This is about as out of sorts as we've seen Stanford's offense all season.
I think you can credit Connecticut's defense for a lot of that.
Ask Gina Auriemma what's changed with his group in the last month of the season as they've started to peak towards the postseason. He said it's all about our defense. That's what's gotten better. That's why we're here.
They're showing it tonight, Holly Nelson Adota, and that's going to be number 4 on Brink. So just like that, no foul trouble all game for Brink, and an offensive foul and a defensive one. And back-to-back possessions, and now Brink is going to have to check out.
The offensive foul was a mistake, but defensively, she's just trying to battle with Nelson Adota. Almost straight up. You've got to be completely straight up so the officials can't make that call.
Rebecca, does it feel like there's been more aggression as Nelson Adota hits the free throw, largest lead of the game here for UConn? A little more aggression from Connecticut's posts offensively in this second half, Edwards and Nelson Adota?
I think they have been more deliberate, Connecticut has, about looking inside and trying to get them the ball as well. Connecticut, once again, extending pressure.
8-point Connecticut lead, their largest of the game. Oh, what a feed! Prechtl to Lexi Hall on the finish. That was a sensational dime, lefty from Prechtl.
You had to deliver it perfectly in order for it to get through.
And a big bucket for Stanford, with Connecticut building some momentum in this fourth. Stanford, the defending national champions. UConn, the most titles all time with 11. Williams, not that time. Long rebound, Mule flags it down. Another chance for Connecticut. No, Jones rips it away. Mule thought she was fouled.
Interesting. Connecticut making a little bit of a run with AZ Fudd on the bench.
Jones bounces out of bounds. Connecticut ball.
Ashton Prechtel, remember, she's a 6'5 big. Look at that. All perfectly placed so Mule can't get her hands on it. I love to see the passing bigs.
I'm not sure why the play-by-play guy said it was with the left hand, but nonetheless, it was gorgeous. Westbrook juggles, kicks out. Here's Beckers. Guarded by Hull, a tough defensive assignment. Hull comes up with a steal. Gets it to her sister. Jump will fire. No. Long rebound. Mule tracked it the whole way. Two on two ball the other end. A lot of good looks for Stanford shooters. They just haven't been able to hit. Meanwhile, Connecticut has gotten very careless with the basketball in this second half. And a loose ball foul there. Westbrook picks up her third personal. Third team foul against Connecticut. And now Fudd is going to check in. Who's she going to get? She's going to get Williams. So Nika Mule is going to stay on the floor here.
Nika Mule has been outstanding. She has 8 rebounds on the game. And because Stanford's now taking threes and missing threes, there's going to be long boards. And she has just been pursuing the basketball.
Stanford has missed its last 9 threes. Beckers comes up with a steal. All the way in for 2. The hometown fans getting into it for Beckers. Played in Hopkins High, 10 miles away from Target Center. Has not played in this building since losing the state championship her sophomore season. Brechtel can't hit. 10 straight misses from 3. How about the rebound from Jones? Overhead and off. Out of bounds off of Stanford. It's Connecticut basketball. And Peckers is shaken up, limping a bit.
Paige Beckers doing a great job jumping the route. She's got long arms, great anticipation, scoring the other way.
Beckers saying, I'm okay, I'm okay. Sort of was grabbing at that right quad area. Had surgery on her left knee. See. Maybe took a shot there from Jones on the right side of her thigh. So Beckers out. Fudd, Mule, and Williams, the three guards for UConn, with Nelson Adota and then Westbrook, the small ball 4, under 5 minutes to go. Fudd didn't take it, will drive it. Can't hit. Nelson Adota the rebound. Brink there for the tie-up, and Stanford has the possession arrow. 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter. UConn, an 8-point lead. A trip to the national championship game is on the line. Buckle up and lock in. Connecticut, an 8-point lead, 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter of this semifinal. They have not been to the national championship game since 2016, trying to get back. Meanwhile, Stanford looking to defend its title. Let's check in with Holly.
Tara Vanderveer just told her squad in the huddle, we've got plenty of time. She's putting Cameron Brink back in the game right now with those 4 fouls. She said, just do the right thing out there, play through it. But right now she's encouraging her team, get it inside. That's where they think they'll find their advantage.
Certainly have plenty of time. And in particular, even though she wants to go inside, with the way Stanford can shoot the 3 ball, they are not out of it, down only 8.
Stanford just 8-for-37 on jump shots in this game. Brink getting it inside, forced it up, drew the foul, and that is going to be number 4 on Olivia Nelson Adota, who's had a really impactful second half. Paige Beckers has been on the bench since dinging that thigh. Brink at the line. hits the first. Cameron Brink, 61% from the line this season. Mom and dad nervously watch. Brink misses the second. Fudge secures it. Aaliyah Edwards getting ready to check in for Connecticut. Nelson Adoda playing with those four fouls. Brink as well. Here's Fudge into Nelson Adoda. Bodying in. Couldn't finish it. Good D from Brink. 7-point Connecticut lead, under four to go. Brink digs in, can't finish, hits the deck. Fudd pushing, Williams stops on a dime, missed the layup, Lacey the rebound, and now Stanford coming the other way.
I'd go back, right back on Nelson Adoda, see if he can pick up the fifth before the sub comes in.
Jumps leaner is good, and it's a 5-point game. Is Connecticut going to take a timeout to get the sub in? No. Paige Beckers walks to the scorer's table now as well. Fudd. Pull-up jumper. Rolls off. Knocked out of bounds. Last touched. Connecticut. It's Stanford basketball. Connecticut fans irate thought it had last hit Brink as Beckers and Edwards check in. Let's see, Rebecca.
Yeah, that's off of Nelson Adoda.
Yep, no doubt. Right call made. Five-point Connecticut lead coming on. 3 minutes to go in the fourth. Here's Brink working on Edwards. Lost her footing and the basketball. Westbrook. One-on-one with Jones. Zips inside, and a foul is called on Haley Jones as Westbrook will shoot two. They coming up tonight on SportsCenter with Nicole Briscoe and Zubin Mehenti. Complete post-game coverage of UConn, Stanford, and Monica McNutt stops by to break down both games. The Game Day crew previews the men's Final Four, and Lakers and Spurs both on the bubble. SportsCenter after UConn, Stanford next on ESPN and the ESPN app. Westbrook has had a big impact in this game. Hit 3 second quarter threes. Misses the free throw here. UConn 4 of 7 from the line. What has to be the focus offensively for Stanford, Rebecca? They've struggled so mightily tonight from 3, 2 for 16.
They've done a nice job getting the ball into Cameron Brink and letting her create. I would like to see Haley Jones get a touch as well, in particular if you can get it to her somewhere 15 feet where she can face up and drive. She's been really good doing that.
Here is Jones, straight on three. No good, off back iron. Lexi comes flying in, soars into Paige Beckers, and the possession arrow belongs to Stanford. And Beckers again in pain.
What effort by Hall, and she loses her balance because she's right with Kristen Williams, and Beckers goes down grimacing again.
Now check that. Possession arrow actually with UConn. So Connecticut basketball with 2:30 to go in this fourth. Leading by six. Beckers in the corner. She traveled. Beckers turns it over. That's been a real issue for Connecticut tonight. Their 16th turnover of the game. Five turnovers for Beckers. 6-point Connecticut lead. Here's Jones into Brink. One-on-one with Edwards. Brink hooks it up and off. Edwards can't control the rebound. It's out of bounds off of her. Another chance here for Stanford. And you can see Gino Auriemma saying, just hug it, hug it. The two winningest coaches in women's basketball history, Tara Vanderveer and Gino Auriemma, have these fans holding on for dear life. Jump, can it the three. Stanford just absolutely frigid from downtown. 2 for 18 now. And Connecticut will take a timeout. 1:50 to go in the fourth quarter. Those kids sensing victory. Connecticut leading by six. 50-44 over Stanford. The Cardinal trying to get back to the national championship game after defeating Arizona in it last season. Also trying to create a rematch with South Carolina after their epic semifinal last year. Connecticut, two timeouts remaining. Stanford with four. No fouls to give. Stanford the possession arrow, and South Carolina doing some early scouting here watching their Sunday night opponent.
And we know late in the NC State games, you know, Auriemma wanted the basketball in the hands of Paige Beckers and AZ Fudd, and he wanted his bigs to just be out there setting screens, not being put in the position of having to make plays. Look for something here. Beckers, AZ Fudd involved.
Sunday, 8 Eastern on ESPN. Who will South Carolina play? Paige Beckers wants to play for another title in her home city. No field goals for Connecticut the last 4 minutes. Beckers gives it up. Fudd, four to shoot. Beckers gonna have to hoist. She does, can't hit. Edwards on the offensive glass, what a rebound. And she draws the foul. Aaliyah Edwards muscles her way to the line.
That was great defense by Stanford to force a tough shot, but Aaliyah Edwards on the inside and fantastic awareness. She knew she was getting fouled, just throw it up there to get to the free throw line.
Edwards with 8 rebounds. Hits the free throw. Edwards, one of just two players who played in every game this season for Connecticut. A year that Gino Auriemma has said has been the most trying of his 37-year career at the helm of the Huskies. And yet, here they are, 126 away from a trip to the national championship game.
Gino Auriemma going defense, offense, substitution right now. Nika Mule in for the defensive end of the floor.
So Paige Beckers on the bench. Jones gallops in and finishes. A quick two from Stanford. 6-point game, and oh my goodness, a turnover on the inbound.
They bobbled it in the exchange of who was going to take the ball out of bounds, and when they did, it was a violation.
Will it come back to haunt Connecticut? Door open. And a foul here against Westbrook is going to put Jones at the line, and Westbrook picks up her fourth.
So here's what happens on the inbounds. Avina Westbrook. Ooh. When she tossed it to Edwards, was Edwards out of bounds yet?
Good question. I'm not sure that she was.
I don't think she was. You're allowed to toss it and then let your player go out of bounds to inbound it. So she's giving it to Edwards. Oh yeah, she had her 1 foot out on that angle and then stepped in.
Jones. Hits them both. Correct call made on that. 4-point game. Westbrook gets fouled in the backcourt by Jones. Both teams are in the bonus at this point, so it's gonna put Westbrook at the line. Now, you don't mind playing the foul game if you're Stanford. You could be aggressive, go for a steal, and worst case scenario, you put Connecticut at the line where they are 7-for-10 tonight. Westbrook 1-for-2. Westbrook hits the first. 11 points from Avina Westbrook. Stanford with 4 timeouts remaining. Westbrook got them both. Ice from Avina Westbrook.
Kelly Jones with a head of steam going towards the rim.
6-point game. Jones, here she goes, spins in, and that is going to be a charge.
Haley Jones has been so good attacking the basket off the dribble. She comes in. Aaliyah Edwards, phenomenal job beating her to the spot on the spin. That's a good call.
Leah Edwards fired up. Gino Auriemma talked about needing solid play out of his post in order to win this game. He's gotten much better than solid in this second half from Edwards and Nelson Adota as Stanford takes the timeout. Connecticut basketball, 104 to go in the fourth. And Connecticut a six-point lead. And Stanford is a really good three-point shooting team, but tonight, 2 for 18 from three. And of course, Rebecca, that's part of the challenge of getting through a tournament comprised of winner-go-home games.
And it's not like they've been missing a lot of easy looks. Both of these teams are terrific defensive teams. And Connecticut, if anything, has been out in the overplay, trying to keep Stanford from getting good looks. And Tara Vanderveer calls that timeout so she can set her team up in their full court pressure defense. See if you can get a steal.
Westbrook, Fudd, Edwards, Beckers, and Williams, the five for Connecticut. Fudd turns it over against the press, a problem in practice before the Elite Eight. And now, oh, Lacy hits the three. It's a one possession game. Williams trying to evade the trap, gets it across. Edwards alone will lay it in. It's a 5-point game.
Gino Auriemma was trying to call a timeout, but the official didn't hear him. He should be thankful for that.
Here's Lexi. She will fire. No. Rebound, Fudd. And Fudd is fouled by Belibi with 40.9 to go, and Connecticut leading by five.
AZ Fudd struggled doing this in practice before the NC State game. The turnover comes. Great job by Hull to step into the three. Gino trying to call a timeout. The official doesn't hear him. The official doesn't hear him. And Leah Edwards says, thank you, official, for not hearing him when she went in for the easy two.
Here is AZ Fudd, number one recruit in the nation this year. The freshman hits the first. AZ's parents into it. AZ hits them both. Mom fired up. It's a 7-point game. Here's Prechtel. A great look. She got it. On a three. It's a 4-point contest. Plenty of time remaining. Here's Fudd dancing her way up the floor. Westbrook nearly throws it away. It does. Williams can't handle it. And it's Stanford basketball in a 4-point game after the turnover.
Westbrook thinks she has enough space to get it to Kristen Williams. Leads her just a little too much. Gino saying, no, no, why?
19 turnovers now for Connecticut. None more crucial than that one. And you could see Gino saying afterwards, too, to Kristen Williams, cut to the hoop there. That's what Westbrook initially thought Williams was going to do, and then she veered off to run clock.
And that's something we saw late in the NC State game. Kristen Williams getting easy buckets when the defense is overcommitted to the side.
A 4-point Connecticut lead.
We're reviewing the last out-of-bounds play for a timing mistake.
All right, so they're going to make sure to get the clock right here. Both teams in the bonus. Each team with two timeouts remaining now.
Certainly not reviewing it to see who it went off on. Right there.
Maybe 28.0 instead of 27.1. Certainly will be a little time put back on the clock here. The interesting.
After review, the correct time on the game clock should be 28.1 seconds. Stanford's ball.
Off by 1/10.
Pretty good by you.
You could see that Westbrook initially thought Williams was just going to cut to the hoop. And then the pass a little off target. So here's Stanford. Now they've hit a couple threes after starting 2 for 18. New life.
But you don't necessarily need a three. Look to attack the basket.
Down four, 28 seconds to go. Jones on the attack. Jones rips it in. It's a 2-point game. 24.4 to go. Fudd is fouled by Jump. And so AZ Fudd will go back to the free throw line, where she has been fantastic all season. Fudd is 29 for 32 from the line this season.
important to make it a two-possession game.
Stanford, two timeouts remaining. They can advance the basketball if they want to. Thud got them both. It's a four-point game. And a timeout is taken. Big free throws from the freshman as Connecticut tries to hold off Stanford down the stretch here.
Stanford has been hitting big shot after big shot the last couple of minutes of this fourth quarter. This is a team so capable of hitting from three, from every position on the floor. Prechtl, one of their bigs. Haley Jones got one to drop as well.
60-56, Stanford with the basketball. Connecticut the four-point lead. One timeout remaining for the Cardinal. Both teams in the bonus. Where does Stanford look offensively here, Rebecca?
All five players on the floor capable of making threes. Good things have happened when Haley Jones has been the one to initiate and create.
Connecticut, meanwhile, 12 for 13 from the line in this fourth quarter. Toss into Brink. Brink trying to find an angle. She does, and it's a two-point game again. And now Connecticut will take a timeout. They will have one remaining. And it's 60-58. Huskies in front, 18.4 to go in the fourth.
What incredible confidence Tara Vanderveer has and Haley Jones and Cameron Brink. You know how difficult of a pass that is to make? Over the top of four players, two of them defenders. Perfect pass, and Brink able to finish with very few ticks coming off the clock.
What a beautiful view of that pass. And now, Rebecca, Connecticut, who struggled at times from the line in the Elite Eight epic contest against NC State, ended up hitting their free throws in overtime. Here they are in the fourth quarter, 12 for 13, and probably going to have to hit a few more to seal this.
First, they've struggled all this game with turning the basketball over.
Yeah.
That is the most important piece of this puzzle, is inbounding the ball. And then Stanford is going to be looking to get a steal quick, and if not, foul.
South Carolina waits to see who they will play Sunday night, 8 Eastern on ESPN in the national championship game.
It reminds me of that semifinal game last year when Stanford could not inbound the basketball late and gave South Carolina that chance at the end.
Bree Beal had a layup she couldn't hit. Aaliyah Boston the follow that was just a tad long. Connecticut 8 fourth quarter turnovers. Just 4 made field goals, trying to get to the finish line and head to the national championship game. Westbrook will inbound. Connecticut advancing the basketball into Edwards. That's who they want to foul. They don't. Edwards finds Thud. Time wasting away. Stanford not fouling, and they finally do. What a missed opportunity from Stanford, as they did not foul Aaliyah Edwards.
They were trying to, and Fran Belibi over on this side of the floor pushed the player down trying to get the foul call. The officials just didn't see it.
So now Williams, the senior, 8 of 12 in the tourney from the line, makes the first. It's a three-point game. Stanford one timeout remaining. They can advance the basketball. Huge free throw here. Two possession lead for Connecticut. And Stanford will spend its final timeout.
Timeout, Stanford.
How about these young women from the line in this fourth quarter? Nails. Connecticut 14 of 15 from the stripe.
A team that has shot under 70% from the line on the season.
Now, Stanford, who has fought so valiantly down the stretch here, finding a way to make this a game in the final moments after it looked like Connecticut was going to wrap this up. The defending champions, who've won 24 straight games. Lexi and Lacey Hall, both seniors, have been just incredible incredible ambassadors of this program. Anna Wilson in her sixth year, playing in her 160th career game, a school record. It'll be the end for her here as well whenever this Stanford run finishes. Now, if you're Stanford, do you have to go for a three now out of timeouts with just 11 seconds left?
With the way Connecticut is shooting free throws in particular, I think yes, you do.
4-point game, 11 seconds to go in the fourth. Prechtl steps back, trying to find an angle, can't hit, out of bounds, Connecticut ball, 5.4 to go. The Huskies can taste it. And now Gino Auriemma is going to take Connecticut's final timeout and advance the basketball with 5.4 to go. Paige's mom all smiles. The Huskies on the cusp of playing for a national championship against South Carolina Sunday night. Connecticut played in the first ever double overtime game in the Elite Eight or later to beat NC State. An unforgettable contest, and now Gino Auriemma, who's 11-10 in national semifinals in his career, but 11-0 in championship games, about to play for a 12th title. Deckers gets it in. Edwards has it. Edwards is fouled with 4.2 to go. Stanford out of timeouts. And one free throw here from Edwards will officially seal it. Just in case there's a heave that goes in with contact.
Okay.
Edwards. Ball game. How about Connecticut? 15 of 16 from the line in this fourth quarter. Edwards misses, and that will do it. The Connecticut Huskies will play for a national title on Sunday night in Minneapolis. They take down the defending champions, 63-58 the final. Stanford's 24-game winning streak snapped. And Gino Auriemma will test his 11-0 record in championship games against South Carolina here at Target Center on Sunday night. As he raises his right arm to a heavy UConn crowd, and Stanford says thank you to their supporters, as they will not have a chance to defend their title Sunday night. The end of the road for the Hull Twins, for Anna Wilson, and an outstanding Stanford team as we take a look at our Capital One rewarding performance, Paige Beckers.
Paige Beckers was absolutely outstanding once again for Connecticut. When they needed her to make plays in the first half, she did, whether it was coming off screens, off the bounce, finding teammates. She was terrific. Whether it was on the offensive end of the floor, making big plays on the defensive end of the floor, Paige Beckers in her second home here at the Target Center.
And Paige is with Holly Ruff.
Paige, another close game down the stretch. Where did this team find the focus play after play to close out this win?
We just kept our composure. We knew Stanford was going to make their runs. They're a really great team and a really competitive team, and they're one of the smartest teams in the country. So we just try to stay composed and stay together.
On paper, this seemed almost impossible. They've got so many players, so many big players. You guys have injuries, a short bench. How did you do it?
We know everybody in the world doesn't think we're going to win, so we're like, we might as well just prove everybody wrong and prove ourselves right. But we got one more game. We're not satisfied with this.
You've played in this building before. You're comfortable here, but the stakes will be higher in your next game. How will you stay locked in and focused in front of this home crowd?
We're just trying to win a national championship and leave everything out on the line. And it's our last game of the season, so we have nothing left to give.
Thank you.
Thank you, Holly.
Well, Paige Beckers, the Minnesota kid, and UConn will face South Carolina Sunday, 8 Eastern on ESPN. For our producer, Kerry Callahan, our director, Jimmy Platt, Holly Rowe, Andrea Carter, and Rebecca Lobo. I'm Ryan Rucco. SportsCenter is coming up next.
Thank you, Ryan. Yeah, hello. Wow, that game, Zubin, had a little bit of everything. And you only needed to watch the last 60 seconds to see it all. But it is UConn. Moving on to the championship game once again, Sunday night. It'll be UConn in South Carolina. This, though, is SportsCenter. Hello, hello. I'm Nicole. He is Zubin. And how about sort of the storybook ending for Paige Beckers? Being able to play the early games just basically on a home court and then playing in the town that built her.
She grew up 10 miles away from the court, the true hometown hero. They've been crowning an NCAA women's champion for 40 years. But all you needed to see was the last 1 minute and 40 seconds of this game. Frantic, heart-pounding, incredible finish. Who will face South Carolina Sunday night for the championship? We mentioned the hometown hero, Paige Beckers, getting it done. Hopkins, Minnesota, just 10 miles away. Stanford had the great interior defense. UConn was shorthanded. Geno talked about it. We'll talk to him in a second. Lacey Hull for three, and then breaking the Stanford pressure up ahead in the open floor is Aaliyah Edwards, and relief. An odd feeling on this stage for UConn. Normally it's a runaway, anything but. 63-58. Wow, with South Carolina awaiting. Let's bring in Geno Auriemma. Coach, thanks for joining us. First things first, just take me through and our viewers through those last 2 minutes.
Why do you want to do that to me? we've been doing this to ourselves all year long. You know, we talk about it all the time. We make some incredible plays. We show some incredible toughness, and then we do things that are just inexplainable, you know. But somehow we always bounce back, and somehow we're always resilient. And we got to the free throw line. We made our free throws. We took care of the ball for the most part. But I thought our defense was incredible all night long. You know, they're an impossible team to defend with all their length and their shooters and their inside game. And the early foul trouble, you know, set us back a little bit. But we really just, I don't know. If you ask me, like, how it happened, I still don't know. But somehow, some way, this team just keeps finding a way to win.
You were open, saying of your 37 years, this was the most trying year of all. I know you still have 40 minutes to get that 12th championship, but I'm just listening to the tone in your voice, Coach. I mean, what has this meant considering everything you've gone through?
Yeah, all year long, you know, it's been, we got to find somebody to do something. We got to find somebody. We don't know who it is. You know, E was in the first half knocking in jumpers to help us, and everybody chipped in a little bit. You know, we didn't rely on one player. And that's the way it's been all year, you know, because we couldn't rely on one player because we didn't know if that player was going to be with us a week, 2 weeks, or a month, or who knows. So it's been emotionally draining and physically for these kids it's been draining. But that's probably the most resilient, toughest team that I've been around in a long, long time.
To emphasize your point, Paige missed 19 games. AZ Fudd missed 11. You don't have Dorka Juhas at the moment. Monday, you won one of the greatest games in the history of the NCAA Women's Tournament. 4 days later, you're playing this sort of game. Take me through the last 4 or 5 days.
Yeah. Starting back with the UCF game, that was an incredible battle, you know, that went down to the wire. And then, the NC State game, was a classic. I mean, both teams deserve to come here, I guess. And then tonight, you know, going into the game, I thought there's no way that this is going to be a runaway for either team. This is just par for the course that it has to end this way. It has to end where it's going to come down to the last couple possessions, and some team's going to have to make some big shots and get some big rebounds. How long can you keep doing that? I don't know. you know, eventually it's going to catch up to us, right? But it has to catch up to us fast because we only got one game left.
Indeed. There's some sort of karma or kismet here. 27 years ago today, you played Stanford in Minneapolis in that building in the Final Four. You won that game, propelled UConn to their first championship, and now, Coach, you're 40 minutes away from your 12th. We will see you Sunday night. Best of luck on championship night.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Jimmy.